Very good morning and warm welcome to my dear children. Let us revise English lesson number 8.
Today we are going to do English Bal Bharati Unit 1 lesson number 8, A Great Leader. This particular lesson is going to cover our English textbook page number 16, 17, 18 and 19. A Great Leader. This particular lesson is about Gandhiji. So before we start with lesson, let us see something about Gandhiji. About a great leader Gandhiji, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi is one of the greatest leaders of all time. He is the father of our nation. He freed Indians from British rules. There are many qualities that Gandhiji had that made him an exceptional leader. So this was about Gandhiji. Now let us begin with the lesson. A great leader. Mahatma Gandhi was one of the greatest leaders of the world. Other leaders win wars by hurting others and killing them. Mahatma Gandhi did not use any armsmen's weapons and equipments used to kill and injure people, and weapons like guns, rifles or bombs. And yet, he won the war of India's independence. People lovingly called him Bapu or Bapuji, that is, father of the nation. Gandhiji was a man of iron will. Iron will means strong determination or willpower. If he decided to do something, he did it, no matter how difficult it was. One day, he decided that he would have an early morning prayer every day. From that day onwards, he never missed the prayer. Gandhiji gave a lot of importance to truth, simplicity and non-violence. That is, not hurting others. Gandhiji's dress was very simple. Just a loincloth, which means a dhoti worn above the knees, and sometimes a shawl. Could he not afford fancy or fashionable clothes? Of course, he could. But the simple loincloth was a deliberate choice. Deliberate means planned. Done on purpose. How did he come to make this choice? Once Gandhiji was on a lecture tour in Odisha, usually men and women gathered in large numbers to listen to him. In Odisha, however, women were not seen at these public meetings or lectures. On making inquiries, Gandhiji found that the people in that part of the country were so poor that their women folk had not a decent thing to wear. What is the meaning of a decent thing to wear? It means an appropriate cloth for the occasion. Okay, so therefore, they kept away from public functions. Gandhiji was deeply pained to hear this. Deeply pained means very unhappy. From that day, he decided to wear the bare minimum of clothes. Bare minimum means the possible that is required, nothing more than that. Be it cold or hot, he never changed his simple dress. Once, he had gone to England to attend a very important conference. Here, he means Gandhiji. So, one day Gandhiji had gone to England to attend a very important meeting. Conference means a large formal meeting where people discuss important matters. King George of England have a reception to the participants of the conference at his palace. Okay, so participants means a person who takes part in a particular activity.
people received by the king have to dress up in a certain way. Means people received by the king, they have to dress up in a proper manner, little, you know, extravagant or something, nice dressing. At that time, England ruled over India. So it was a talk about a time where, you know, England ruled over India. People in England wanted to know if Gandhiji would change the style of his dress to see the king. Gandhiji made it very clear that he would be dressed in his usual way. That means he is not going to change his dressing style. Even when visiting the king of England, he would wear the dress of the people whom he represented. Gandhiji was not bothered. Not bothered means not worried by what style of dress the British approved of. So long as the poor people in his country did not have enough clothes to wear. So unless people in own country did not have enough clothes to wear, even he is going to dress up in same manner. Finally, the king had to welcome at his reception. This great man dressed in a simple loincloth and a shawl. The king himself was dressed quite extravagantly. Extravagantly means in a way that cost a lot of money. Quite expensive cloth. Gandhiji was asked whether he had enough clothes on for meeting with the king. He replied that the king had enough clothes on for both of them. Millions of poor people in India felt very happy that Mahatma Gandhi dressed like them. He did not wear anything extravagant, you know. So what happened? Although Mahatma Gandhi did not use any destructive weapons, destructive means something that cause damage, you know. He had millions of staunch followers. Staunch followers means very, loyal followers. Those who believed in Gandhiji like anything completely. Gandhiji showed all the suppressed people. Suppressed people means those people who have been prevented from developing or growing freely. Suppressed people in the world, the new path of Satyagraha. He is remembered for his greatness, not only...
Dear children, after revising the entire lesson in this above video, here are two important leaders of that time about whom we should also know. Like Gandhiji, Lokmanya Tilak also gave his life for freedom, for Swaraj. His motto was to free India from British rule. So, let's see a small information on Lokmanya Tilak. Lokmanya Tilak, Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. The person who asserted this was Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Bal Gangadhar Tilak was born in 1856. At that time, the British ruled over India. People did not like this British rule. They agitated against the British government. Lokmanya Tilak inspired a national spirit among the people. For that purpose, he organized public celebrations of Ganeshotsav, Shivaji Jayanti in his papers Kesari and Maratha. He boldly criticized the government. The British government arrested Tilak and put him in prison. But Lokmanya Tilak continued his struggle for Swaraj even after he was released from prison. He spent all his life in the service of the nation. So he was a very great man. Dear children, Lokmanya Tilak was born in the year 1856. And when he was born, at that time, British was ruling on our country. People did not like British rule because British were treating Indians like just a poor and downtrodden person. They were not at all giving any importance or giving any kind of respect to Indians. They were only and only burdened with hard and physical work, and they were not given any proper money or proper credit of it. So Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Lokmanya Tilak's full name is Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He decided to inspire people. To inspire means to encourage people. And he also developed a spirit of a national spirit among the people so that people can come together. He boldly criticized, means he opposed government at that time. And dear children, nowadays we can use FM radio or television or Facebook. There are various kind of social medias, but at that time there was only one media which was very useful and which was very popular, that is newspapers. And Lokmanya Tilak was writing in introduced Kesari and Maratha newspaper, and this was a strong platform for him to criticize against government. And he did the same through his papers, through his writings. He criticized government and showed people the right color of British, and also inspired people. To inspire them, he also celebrated certain festivals like Ganeshotsav and Shivaji Jayanti so that people can come together, they can understand the importance of unity, and they can come and unitedly fight to free India. Dear children, Lokmanya Tilak, he gave a very strong slogan for us, that is, Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. Dear children, birthright means basic right of human beings. I should be freed. I should be freed. This is my right. This is my birthright. So, this was a very strong and popular slogan given by Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak to us, that is, Swaraj is my birthright and I will have it. This was a small information on Lokmanya Tilak. This information is also given in your textbook, page number 18. So whenever you get time, you can read it again by opening your textbook. Okay? Is that clear? Here is another great leader of that time. This time, it's a female leader of that time. Dear children, before introducing this female leader, I would like to share a small piece of information with you, that during that time, females were not given any importance. They were only considered as, you know, as a maid in the house. She was not included, or she was not asked her opinion. Females were not allowed to study also. They were not having right to speak about injustice happening against them. They were just like a non-living things, only for working. They were at home, like household work, taking care of kids, taking care of elderly person. They were not allowed or not given any importance in the society. But this lady which we are going to speak about, we are going to learn about now, that is Savitri Bai Phule. She is the person because of whom we females are now studying, going ahead. We got exposure to the world. She is the one who took due efforts to educate girls at that time. Let's see this information on page number 19 of our textbook. Savitri Bai Phule. Today, we see that girls go to school, colleges, and excel in every walk of life along with men. But this was not always so. In the past, women and the downtrodden sections of the society did not have the right to education. They were not allowed to work in any important position. Their life was miserable. This was a great social injustice. Social reformers fought against this injustice and discrimination. Foremost among them were Mahatma Jyotirao Phule and his wife Savitri Bai Phule. Mahatma Phule started the first school for girls in Pune in 1848. In the face of great social opposition, at a time when women were not allowed to read and write, Savitri Bai became the first woman to teach in a girls' school. To stop her, people created many obstacles in her path. They even threw dirt and stones at her, but she did not waver. She did not give up her noble cause. Her nobility and courage will always guide men and women alike in the course of life and career. Dear children, especially girls, we should be very thankful to Savitri Bai Phule. Because of her, we are studying. If she did not oppose, or if she did not any time, she thought, "Arey, why should I try to bring change?" And she would have given up. As I told you, as I read it in this, that people also, to oppose her this good deed, they threw dirt and they threw stones on her to stop her from doing this good, noble task. She did not give up. She would have thought, "No, why should I oppose? Let it be. I am safe at my home." She did not think, you know, what you say. त्यांनी म्हणजे कधी असा विचार नाही केला, आपला स्वतःचा एकटीचा विचार नाही केला, किंवा सेल्फिश बिहेवियर त्यांनी नाही दाखवलं. शी थॉट की माय वन ट्राय और माय वन अपोजिशन कॅन गिव अ वर्ल्ड टू गर्ल्स, टू फीमेल्स, नॉट ओनली टू गर्ल्स बट टू फीमेल्स जोज हू आर ॲट होम. देर वर मेनी, सी वी कॅन सी नाव in today's world, girls are ahead of men's. They are progressing, they are exploring world, they are exploring sky, they are going to space. Yes or no, my dear children? Yes. You have remembered of our famous scientist. Yes or no? So dear children. She was the one because of whom girls could take basic school education. And you know what? Who supported her for this noble task? Her husband, Mahatma Phule. He helped and he was strongly with her till entire struggle. And he, because of his support, she could form a school for girls in Pune in 1848. And the time when the society did not give any right for women to take education, or women were even not allowed to go out of the house, my dear children. At such times, she brought girls to school and she gave them encouragement. She prepared them mentally. She prepared them completely for studies. And she formed or established a first school for girls, where girls could take basic education. So this was small information on Savitri Bai Phule. She was a great lady. So we have studied about Mahatma Gandhi, Lokmanya Tilak and Savitri Bai Phule. You should remember great work done by them and the great values given to us by them. We should try to follow these good and great values. Meet you tomorrow in the next video. Till that, bye, take care, have a nice day.